So in 1962, my dear, dear friend, Mary Monroe, was found dead soon after her breakup with President John Kennedy. My friend was gone. She was just gone. They told her lies, and she fell for it. She fell hard. Oh, I missed her. In some ways, and we both achieved great success. Great success in the industry. Films, recordings. But she, of course, had more power and clout and more recognition due to the racism in this country. Crazy. And she had such great strength and power, determination. Here in 1955, oh no, I didn't let my breakup with Otto stop me. I kept working. Then in 1962, also during the bankruptcy filing, Helen Calvin didn't know I existed. Oh. Then in 1964, in April of 1964, I bounced back and some work came in. Earl got me working in Mexico, Puerto Rico, and Tokyo. Yes, I was working again. But every penny I made was on Fountain Avenue in West Hollywood. Marilyn had lived there before. We spent many sunny days sitting on the outside steps, talking about our lives and dreams and goals and all the children we were going to have. Maybe next year I can have a baby. Never know. Bled at me. Wouldn't even touch me. Now I know he would have given me money, but I didn't want nothing from him. I hoped that he could see me and feel guilty. Him and Hollywood! And Jack Dennison making me work in his club. They had headlines. Dorothy Dandridge resolved to be a saloon singer. Zanuck was begging me to take the part. They called, they waited, and you told me not to take it. Oh, your career accelerated, and I lost mine. I should never have listened to you.